Doug Kide here with Zach Cox at MetLife Stadium in New Jersey, getting ready for the Patriots' fourth and final preseason game against the Giants. But the biggest news of the day, probably the biggest news of the night as well, don't expect much to happen in this preseason game, is that Rob Gronkowski reportedly agreed, or I guess it's more than reportedly since his agent announced it, agreed to a contract restructuring where the Patriots basically added, what was it, about $4 million to his contract here?
Yeah, 4.3, I believe.
Yeah, so talk about some of the incentives, I guess, that are part of this contract that the reporters have thrown out there.
So basically, last season, Rob Gronkowski had 69 receptions for 1,084 yards and 8 touchdowns and played 79% of New England's plays. If he betters any of those numbers by even 1 yard, one reception, one touchdown, then he gets $1.1 million. And if he plays in all 16 games, I believe he gets another $1 million. Is that correct?
Yep.
So he's allowed to hit up to 3 of those. So really, to me, this seems like a pretty good deal for both sides. I mean, Rob Gronkowski finally gets the contract restructuring that seems to have been in the works for months now. I mean, I remember back in May and June, we were kind of expecting some report to come out imminently. It took a little bit longer than expected, but he finally has that deal. He has to have a very good season to get the full value of this deal. But, I mean, knowing Rob Gronkowski, it's very, very probable even that if he remains healthy, he can hit all of these incentives, end up taking home just north of $13 million, rather, which would make him one of the highest paid tight ends in the league, which is probably where he should be.
Yeah, and one of the really, I guess, interesting or important part of this contract restructuring is that Rob Gronkowski didn't hit those marks last season, which means that it's a not likely to be earned incentive, which means that it doesn't count against this year's salary cap. If he does get those bonuses, if he does get those incentives, then it will count against next year's salary cap. So the Patriots still have about $7 million in cap room, maybe a little bit less if you take into account that those roster bonus, those in-game bonuses that Rob Gronkowski will get. But that's definitely an important part of this deal because the Patriots do want to acquire any players before the season starts, and that will count against the salary cap. So to get Rob Gronkowski's contract reworked while not taking the salary cap hit is big.
Yeah, it's definitely an important distinction. And for people who maybe see this report out on Twitter or read these contract details, not likely to be earned just means it's more than he received. The numbers are higher than what he hit last year. It's not saying Rob Gronkowski is not likely to get 9 touchdowns or 70 catches or whatever.
It's a technicality.
It's a technicality, but it's a technicality that works in the Patriots' favor in this
Definitely.
Case.
And like I said earlier, the Patriots are taking on the Giants in their fourth and final preseason game tonight. And there's kind of three things to watch for in this game. First of which is the players who are not going to play. That likely means that they are making the Patriots' 53-man roster on Saturday. That's when the Patriots have to do their cutdowns. Other thing to watch is veterans who play deep into this game. That means that those guys are still, you know, fighting for roster spots. And the third thing really is young players who are getting snaps in this game, because that also means that they're fighting for roster spots. And this is their last chance to prove to either the Patriots or another team that they deserve to be on a roster. So taking that into account, in the first category there, guys who might not play in this game and might have already locked down spots on the 53-man roster, I'm looking to see if Keontae Davis, the defensive end, stays on the sideline the whole time, and maybe even cornerback J.C. Jackson, if he stays on the sideline the whole time. What about those veteran guys who might be playing deep into this game?
Yeah, Jason McCourty is the big guy that I'm watching in that category. The Patriots switched him to safety midway through last week's game, a position he's never played in his life until last week, which really shows that I think they want to keep him on this roster. They're just trying to find a reason to keep him on this roster, because based purely on cornerback play, I don't know if he has a spot right now. So he's going to be one player to watch in that regard. I expect him to play tonight. I think if Jason McCourty plays in this game, it doesn't mean that he's not making the team.
Right.
If he's on the field deep into the fourth quarter, that's probably not a very good sign for him. Another guy is Mike Gillisley in that same category. Both he and Jeremy Hill played deep into the fourth quarter of the third preseason game last week, which is a bit of a surprise to a lot of us to see Hill still out there, because I think most of us have kind of gotten the sense that Jeremy Hill has the edge in that roster battle. But the fact that both of them are still out there so deep into that Panthers game suggests that maybe that battle is a little bit closer than some observers and some media members may be thinking. So if one of those two running backs is still in the game late in this game, I think that could not be a great sign for them.
Really, the most entertaining thing to watch in this game, I guess, is those young guys who are still battling for roster spots. I would put wide receiver Riley McCarron in that mix. He hasn't had the greatest preseason, hasn't had the greatest training camp, but just given the Patriots' numbers at wide receiver right now, you have to assume that they want to keep around a fourth wide receiver. Someone just has to earn that. So I think that Riley McCarron, out of the guys who are going to be in this game who have not yet locked down roster spots, is probably the most likely. It's possible that we see Braxton Berrios, the rookie wide receiver. It's possible that we see a lot of Devin Lucien, Paul Turner, KJ May. But really in that mix, Riley McCarron has the best shot to earn a spot. There are three new players on the Patriots roster for this game who had not played before this. That is KJ May, the wide receiver, very low chance of making the roster, and two running backs, Kenneth Farrow and Kalfani Muhammad. Those guys are more interesting. Kalfani Muhammad is probably the smallest running back in the NFL. He's 5'7", 174 pounds, but he's extremely fast. He's kind of a Deion Lewis type who might return some kicks, might just be a nice little audition for him, either for the Patriots practice squad or a 53-man roster spot somewhere else, maybe a practice squad spot somewhere else. Kenneth Farrow actually started games for the San Diego Chargers back in 2016. I did say that correctly. San Diego Chargers. Now the LA Chargers, but it was while they were still in San Diego. So I expect to see a lot of work out of Kenneth Farrow. He's a bigger back. I think he's like 5'9", 215. He was basically out of the NFL last year. He was on the Chargers injured reserve all season with an ankle issue. So it's a good chance for him to get some film out there, either for the Patriots or someone else. He was a guy that the Chargers were high on at one point, so maybe it's possible that another team could look at him and say, all right, we'll sign him to the practice squad or maybe even roster him.
Definitely a possibility. I'm not really expecting any of those three new guys to really have a chance of sticking around on the 53-man roster. No. Like you said, very possible that any of them could wind up on the practice squad. Same thing for Ralph Webb, who was kind of everybody's darling after that week one of the preseason. Haven't seen much of him since then. You don't know if the Patriots are maybe trying to hide him a little bit from other teams so they can sneak him on the practice squad. Maybe the same case with Danny Etling, the quarterback. We don't know how much we're going to see from him tonight. But another player that I'm really going to be watching is Cyrus Jones. Mm-hmm. He's a guy who probably would have made the 53-man roster last year based on his punt return ability if he didn't go down with that ACL tear. Obviously, everybody in New England remembers Cyrus Jones as the guy who really couldn't do anything right as a rookie back in 2016. But in a small sample size, he's looked pretty good as a punt returner and as a kick returner so far this preseason. And the fact that basically seems to be him and Riley McCarron are kind of they're both on the roster bubble, and if one of them makes it, it's basically because he's going to be used as a punt returner until Julian Edelman returns. I thought it was interesting that Cyrus Jones got reps there last game, but Riley McCarron did not. Mm-hmm. So you might be able to kind of read out of that he might be a little bit higher on that depth chart. But I think that's going to be maybe one of the more interesting roster battles here, because I think those two guys are maybe fighting for the 52nd or 53rd spot on this roster, and it's going to be as a punt returner. So we'll see who handles that role tonight. We'll see who plays well in that role tonight. And I think either of them still have the chance to make the team, but someone's going to have a big game tonight.
Yeah, just the final guy, you mentioned him earlier, Danny Etling. We don't really know who's going to be playing quarterback in this game, whether it is going to be Brian Hoyer, whether it is going to be Danny Etling. And if it's not Etling, then I think that really goes to show that the Patriots are really trying to hide him, make sure that they could pass him through waivers onto their practice squad. I think that would be the ideal situation this season, to get him onto the practice squad, to not have him on that 53-man roster. But we'll see how high the Patriots are on him. If he does play in this game, we'll see how well he plays, because we've really barely seen him throughout the summer in training camp or the preseason.
Something like 17 or 19 snaps overall. Yeah, really not much of him at
very
all.
Very little. So the game kicks off at 7 p.m. Follow Nest.com for all of your Patriots coverage. Follow me on Twitter at Doug Kide. Follow Zach on Twitter at Zach Cox Nesson. And like I said, keep it on Nesson.com. We'll have a post-game video coming up after the game.